in here, so we got to make up the ground on a lot of these teams.
How do you catch up? How do you make up that ground?
You know, a lot of relationships have already been built. You know, I knew a lot of guys when I left Auburn, especially in the Georgia area, in the South Carolina area, in the North Carolina area. We even knew some of the guys up in this Tennessee area. So there were relationships built, contact being made with some of these guys. So it's not like we're new to them. Butch Jones' name is huge. A lot of folks knew exactly who he was and know what he stands for. So it's, you know, we're trying to get as many kids in front of him as we can when we start in January.
How much does your SEC experience, coaching experience, help this staff? Because there's not a lot on the staff with SEC experience.
Yeah, but the coaching is coaching. And again, it's the same jungle to all of them. You've got to get players. They understand that. Butch understands it. And guys, the great thing I like about them, they're asking the questions on, is there real life boogeyman in some states, you know? And I tell them, it's as different as any place you're going to be. Any conference, you know, ACC, the Big Ten, the Big 12, everyone thinks that that's the conference, but this is the most competitive conference in America.
When you were in, were you in on the meeting the other day with the former players?
No, sir, I was not. No, sir.
Just in talking, you mentioned Butch's name. When you talk to guys down, you mentioned his name. What kind of reaction did you get?
Well, they understand. I mean, I've always had a relationship with a guy named Zach Azania on staff, and he was my GA back probably about 10 years ago. And he used to tell me back then, hey, man, this guy named Butch, I mean, he just watched it. He's going to move through the ranks. And lo and behold, it's come to life. His name was big even when he was down in Auburn. You know, they won at Cincinnati, won 10 games. That's hard to do. You're playing teams like the West Virginias and the Rutgers. Those teams are competitive every single year. And to go in and to win 10 games a year, that's a feat that's to be recognized.
Have you had any opportunity to look at your side of the ball, your guys, is what they did last
year?
Yeah,
we've cut a little bit of tape on. Hadn't analyzed it as much as we need to yet, but it's coming. The first thing we're trying to do is making sure we don't fall behind on the recruiting. Now we've kind of got that under control. Now it's time to start watching tape on our current guys.
How much have you relied on Jay Graham for his input?
Jay's been valuable, especially with a lot of the relationships with some of the kids he already have here. So, again, he had a lot of contact with guys, so it was easy for him to pass the phone around. Then when you say the name Jay Graham, he played here. A lot of guys know of him. So it was a really good transition for him to be part of our staff.
We talked a little bit about the SEC's a different monster. On the defensive side, I think Coach Jancic, Coach Martinez, you all have an extensive SEC experience. Just how important is that on the defensive side of the ball, even Coach Jones in his – introductory press conference mentioned.
Yeah, every single week it's a game of the week. You know, even now with Vanderbilt up, you know, you're playing the Vanderbilts, you're playing the South Carolina, you're playing the Florida, you're playing the Georgia. When is there a down game? There is no such thing as a down game. So every week you got to put your A game on and go out to practice with your construction hat on and be ready to go. There is no letdowns in this conference because every single week anybody can beat you. And that's what Butch understands. Everywhere he's gone, he's kept intensity high and understands every week you got to play it like it's a national championship.
Speaking of national championship, you won one, you've been around a program before. What does it take to get there? What do you see here that maybe needs to get there?
I tell you what we sold at Auburn, you know, we sold a lot of tradition and family. And then the tradition is longer here at Tennessee. When I played ball at the University of North Carolina, that was always a team, Tennessee. You know, they would come in our state, take the best players, the Heath Schulers out the state, the Jay Grahams out the state. They took a lot of great football players from us. T. Martin and winning the national championship. Peyton Manning being here and winning, 11, 12 ball games a year. You know, winning the SEC conference, they were doing it consecutively year in and year out. So the name is big, the tradition big, football is big here. So, yeah, when I was at Auburn, you know, we had a difference maker at quarterback. We had a difference maker on defense, but Tennessee, we should have difference makers of two or three of those guys on offense and on defense.
You played for Mack Brown, right?
Yes, sir, I did. North Carolina from 89 to 93.
What did you learn from Mack Brown?
Mack taught me a lot just far as, you know, as far as big picture and in relationships with people. Probably the best speaker I've ever been around. I learned a lot through him and just how to have human relationships and communication, nonstop communication. Through him, hard work, dedication, always, you know, keep a clean image. That's what I've always done as a coach. That's one of the reasons I wanted to go into coaching because of the guys he had on his staff and what they stood for. And even today, every job I've ever been on, I'll always call Mack for guidance. And he was the one, when I talked to him about this job, he said, you got to go to Tennessee.
Why? Why did he say that?
Because he said, same reason he told me I had to go to Auburn. When I was at North Carolina, and I was there for 4 years with Butch Davis, and the Auburn job came up. And he told me, hey, you got to take the Auburn job. it's a step for you. It's a better step for your career. Now at Auburn, you know, I had a couple other job offers here around the country, and he said, "Dick, SEC is where it's at. That's where you need to go. Tennessee got great tradition. You know he's from the state. Carl Torbush is from the state. One of my old coaches and my position coach said the same thing. Said, Tennessee, that's the place you want to go."
Did you coach for Urban Meyer?
Yes, sir. I coached 2 years at Bowling Green with Urban Meyer.
What did you learn from Urban Meyer?
Urban was always stay on your kids. You know, they never, ever turn your back and think that somebody else is doing your job. He was really good at making sure you communicated nonstop with the kids, always know what they were doing, and then be demanding on them. So I've pulled a little bit from each guy, from the Butchers, from the Urbans, from John Bunnings, from James Reese at Tennessee State. You learn a little bit from each guy, and you kind of pull it into your own personality in the coaching field.
When you were at Tennessee State, what were your thoughts of the University of Tennessee?
They were too big. I was young and really naive then, and you're looking at Tennessee State, and I'm thinking, man, I would like to go up against those guys and try to snatch a player from them or two. But no, there was no way. If they, on signing day, if you had a kid committed, and you probably had him committed for a year and a half or whatnot, Tennessee called him on signing day, he was gone. That's just, I mean, I'd look at him differently now because I mean, that's, if you got an opportunity in this state, this is where you want to be at. This is the University of Tennessee. We are the premier school in the state.
What's the most important thing you want to instill in a defensive back?
In DBs, you want, again, the one thing you're always looking for in trait are, you know, speed, makeup speed, and then just the physicalness of the DBs. So for us, again, one thing we want to instill is toughness, smartness and toughness in the secondary.
Tommy, there's probably only one way this defense can go, and that's up after last year. Can it be a quick fix, do you think, or is it going to take some time?
I don't think there's, in this conference, there's no such thing as a quick fix. Our whole goal is going to be just to get better, and then see the improvement every single week. And so, again, we're not looking to jump from whatever we ranked last year to number one, number two. What we need to make sure happens is there'll be a steady improvement every single week and every day they come to work.
You've got experience in this conference. These guys are rolling in here from the Big East. Is you think they're ready for what the SEC is all about, or does that coaching sort of transition happen a little easier than maybe we give them credit for?
Yeah, Butch has an edge. He coaches with an edge. And we're looking to have that same personality in our players. Again, when Tennessee was good, players here played with a chip on their shoulders. And that's the same chip that Butch has on his.
What do you think makes you such a good recruiter? You've got a reputation of an outstanding recruiter.
Just relationships with people, doing backgrounds, go all the way back to your grandmother, your grandfather, the restaurants in your town. I mean, when we recruit you, we find out every little thing about you, and then when you come here, make it all feels like home.
How eager are you about playing freshman right off the bat?
I have no problem, but I've done that in the past. And even when I was at the University of North Carolina, I had two linebackers that came in as true freshmen. Just threw them out there. Bruce Carter, who now starts with the Dallas Cowboys, and then Quan Sturdivant, who was with the Arizona Cardinals. Had no problem with throwing them out there and getting them to learn. Really, that's the only way for them to learn.
How much have you had a chance to analyze the personnel?
I haven't had much time to analyze them yet because, again, we were behind on the recruiting. But now, today, tomorrow, all the way through the break, the Christmas holidays, taking all the tapes back home with me and making sure I get a chance to analyze and critique each player.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
In terms of change, can change, I don't ever want to do change just for the sake of change, I guess, but for those guys that went through that season, one of the worst in program history in terms of yards allowed and points allowed, can just some new faces help with some of those kids?
Again, there's always room for improvement. And I don't know what the situation was last year. It would be unfair for me to even speak about it. All we want to do is when we get here is make sure these kids improve every single week and that they have an enthusiasm about doing it. And that's the number one goal, improve them every week.
Have you been able to sense, I know you've met just here and there with some of the guys, can you sense some of that enthusiasm? It seems like more and some of the other guys are pretty excited.
Yeah, I mean, again, it's a new start for them, and it's a new start for us. You know, there's for us as we walk into it, there are no biases. You know, we don't know anything about, you know, the things they had in their past, the things, what's going on in their personal lives, we have no idea. So all we can do is go in there with an open mind, hold no grudges against kids. It's a fresh start for some guys. They may have, the passion for the game may have left, and may hope this is a chance for some of those guys to come back and, you know, rebound from if they were struggling with something in the past. So, you know, we've seen it before, and each coach and as a player, we want the kids to come in here and just understand that the expectation is going to be high. And, you know, the intensity on the field is going to be high. And, again, even off the field is going to be high. So for us, again, improvement, improvement, improvement. We can't say that enough.
I think I'm wondering, when you were hired at Auburn, it was kind of a change to kind of start this staff from scratch and hired one by one, and it took a while. Whereas here, bringing a lot of guys who have been with him for a long time.
Correct.
How does that change the dynamic? I mean, Coach Jones was saying that you can hit the ground running a little bit more, but for you, who's kind of new to the mix with these guys, how does it change the dynamic, if at all?
I don't think it does at all. I mean, men are men, and we've all got the same passions. I think that's what he was trying to make sure he got on the staff, with guys that were great football coaches as well as great recruiters. And that's what you'll see in our staff and the chemistry of our staff. It's just not the football coaches on the staff. It's both. You got to do both of them. You know, you just can't say I'm a great recruiter and I can't coach. It doesn't add up. You got to be a great coach, a great teacher, to make sure that these kids get a fair chance when they go out on the field and be able to compete in the SEC.
You may have already been asked this, but was Willie kind of a link as far as you asking him about the staff and him telling
no doubt,
you about
no doubt.
It?
No doubt. Willie and I worked together for a year, and we had a great bond with each other this season. I learned a lot from him, and I believe he learned a lot from myself as well. And he know what I stand for, and I know what he stood for. I mean, both of us believe in hard work and never compromise your kids. Every day, bring them out there, and it's a work environment. And again, when they come off the field, they're in the office, they're learning the game. And again, we're going to hold them all accountable and never compromise them.
I'm Evan Woodbury. I covered you for